The lift actuator was a three-way ball valve, so an L port and a T port ball valve. They're set up in the position that, in the closed position, A port A and C are connected in the L port, and in the open position, port C and B connected. Now, this is set up with the indicator, so red is closed, has that on the indicator, yellow is open on the indicator. We also supply a label which goes on the top of the actuator and shows you the ports allowed underneath, so check that label. So the L port ball valve, when the electric actuator is set up, as I said before, it's set up in the closed position. So once you look at it, you should be able to identify the A and C port. And now looking down the top, which in this direction, I'm looking from the label front of the actuator, and also the C and B. The C is the port on the side of the T, A and B is the through port. That's for the L port. The T port ball valve is set up so that it's set up in the closed position, and once again, the close will be red, as it is up in here, and the open is yellow, and it's set up so that in the closed position, the flow goes through that leg of the T, A to B, and in the open position, it switches around to this direction, and ports A and C are connected. This applies, this setup here applies to all of the bigger, all the actuators, all the electric actuators, right from 09 through to 013 for L port, T port ball valves. For the OM1 and OMA, these stops are done with micro switches internally. If for some instance the operator takes the manual override, and if you don't isolate the manual override operators, fiddle with it. It's probably best to always isolate it. If they do operate it and they take it past its 90 degrees, so we always have a rotation of 0 to 90 in an actuator. Normally, with the OM2 to 13, they have stops on there, so it's a mechanical stop. It can't go through its 90 degree rotation. However, with the OM A and 1, you can manually, when the power's off, put it into the 270 degree area. Suggestion is to turn, if it does go into this area, to reset it. You take your external switch, which you come here for your on-off switch and your external power supply. Put your power back on, switch this in one direction, leave it there until the rotation takes place, switch it back in the other direction, and the unit will rotate right around and reset itself automatically. It will reset itself in the position that you want to set your switch at.